So a lot of us work with more than one screen on our Mac, whether it's a MacBook that has a screen attached or maybe a Mac Pro or Mac Mini that has multiple screens. We know that not only do they exist in a physical space close to each other when we're using them, but also there's the idea that the desktops are virtually close to each other in how they interact, how the cursor moves from one to the other, how Windows moves from one to the other. So let's take a look at how you can adjust that to get it just right for you. Here's my setup. I have three screens. I've got an older 30-inch monitor in the middle, and then I have two rather inexpensive 1080 monitors on either side that I've set to vertical. And when I go into System Preferences and I look at Displays, I can click on Arrangement and I could see a representation of those screens here. And this is where I can control where they are virtually. Now I want them, of course, to look close to how they do physically. So for instance, the default may have actually been to have this screen lined up here with the top, but that's not how it looks on my desk. So it's rather confusing when I try to move the cursor from one screen to another. It doesn't pop up where I want. And if I'm at the bottom, say, of the left screen here, and I try to move to the right, I can't get anywhere, even though it looks like I should be able to go right to this screen. So you want to adjust these screens any way you want. You can drag and drop any way you want to make them look like the screens that you have now. You can even move them around very easily. So if they're in the wrong positions virtually compared to where they are physically, you just basically drag and drop them around. So line them up to get them kind of where you want them to be. That would be something somewhat accurate, but I kind of like it here because I think of the bottom edges of the screen as lined up. Also, another thing to notice is this bar at the top. This is the menu bar and it tells you what screen is default. I can actually drag that menu bar to another screen. So if you ever find when your Mac starts up or wakes up, if the menu bar is always in the wrong place, or if when you run new apps they always appear on the wrong screen, then use this menu bar, drag it around and put it on the screen that you want as your main screen. Now not all apps, not all windows are going to open based on this. It's a starting point, but for instance if you're using an app and you're using it on one screen and then you quit the app and you open it again, it's probably going to put the window back where it was before. But you definitely do want to have this menu bar on the screen that you think of as your main screen. Have these adjusted to where you want and make sure that you have it all set and try things out, play around with it and get it to where you're comfortable. Also notice you can hit Gather Windows. Gather Windows actually brings together all of the displays onto one screen here so I can see them. Otherwise this one was on one side and this one was on the other and then this one was the only one that we saw here in my screen capture. And notice you can set things like this. This is how I've rotated those two displays 90 degrees. They're not set to standard. This one's set to 90. This is set to 270 so that the screens are vertical on either side. And that's done in display. And here of course I've got the rotation of the center one set to standard there. And then notice I can also adjust color separately for each one of those as well because different screens will be made by different manufacturers and you may want to adjust color separately for each one of those. So that's how you deal with having multiple screens on your Mac. I know a lot of people that have multiple screens but haven't taken the time to really play around with the screen placement here, and it's definitely worthwhile doing.